Have you heard about School Incorporated? It's a new PBS series that looks at America's schools and schools around the world. It makes interesting points about what's wrong with our schools and what might be done about that. The series, though, is long. It's 3 hours. So here's my Stossel short attention span version.
Recognize this? It's the original Sony Walkman introduced in 1979. The first mainstream personal music player.
That was just the beginning. Every year or two, new and improved models hit the market. To earn enough to buy the original Walkman, you had to work 2 weeks at a typical minimum wage job. And that was for lo-fi sound on cassettes you had to flip over every half an hour. What's really amazing about the rapid spread and improvement of personal audio players is that it isn't amazing at all. It's perfectly normal. A decade ago, no one had ever heard of Google. Now they do tens of thousands of internet searches per second. Facebook went from zero to 500 million members in just 5 years. Basically, invent something good, and it gets big. And these days, it gets big fast. But of all the products we make and the services we provide, there's one that stands out as an exception to that overall pattern. One activity in which excellence doesn't spawn countless imitators or spread on a massive scale. And that exception is schooling. For generations, there hasn't been a single innovation in teaching that has transformed classrooms and improved student achievement worldwide.
Why not? In America, the education establishment always says, we need more money to make schools better. But America's been trying that. We tripled spending on government-run schools over the past 50 years. And yet,
American test scores at the end of high school have been flat since we started keeping track of them all the way back in the early 1970s. Basically, educational quality has been stuck in the era of disco and leisure suits. And while our top athletes and pop stars reach huge audiences, our greatest teachers seldom reach more than a few dozen kids at a time. Why not? That's the question at the heart of this series.
Colson found some answers as to why the best teachers don't teach more kids at California's Garfield High.
By 1988, more students were passing the Advanced Placement Calculus test here at Garfield than at Beverly Hills High. One out of every four Mexican-Americans who passed AP Calculus nationwide attended Garfield. Why?
Jaime Escalante.
Jaime Escalante.
Jaime Escalante.
Time, 3 seconds.
As a teacher, he was fantastic.
From the time he started teaching at Garfield in 1974, Jaime Escalante worked as if his life depended on the success of his students.
There was nothing but excellence expected of us students.
So we did not want to disappoint Jaime.
By 1982, the results were beyond belief. Literally, his students performed so far above expectations on the AP Calculus test that the Educational Testing Service suspected cheating and threw out their scores. Undaunted, they retook it and came through with flying colors a second time. Hollywood noticed, dramatizing the story in the movie Stand and Deliver.
This is basic math, but basic math is too easy for you burros.
Seeing the movie makes me laugh. It gives me a lot of memories of how it was in the classroom. He taught me everything I needed to be prepared for college.
In art as in life, Escalante had a simple message for his students. With enough drive and hard work, the sky was the limit.
When his students went to college, they found they were extra well prepared.
Every one of those classes that I took, there was always a subject that I had already learned in Mr. Jaime Escalante's class in high school.
Louder! A negative becomes a negative equals a positive.
Why?
The movie Stand and Deliver ends on a high note, with Escalante's students proving the skeptics wrong. But the story of his mathematics program at Garfield does not have a Hollywood ending.
Every single week, there was a new film crew coming in.
In any other field, we might expect this combination of success, scalability, and publicity to have catapulted Escalante to the top of his profession. Or like Hubble's expanding universe, to have spread all across the country. That just isn't what happened.
A lot of the teachers were resentful, and it was very public.
The key problem was that Escalante's classes were big.
He could handle it.
He was setting a precedent. He was giving the message to the administrator, you know, if Escalante can do it, why not you?
So the teachers' union marshaled enough votes to oust Escalante as head of the math department.
Demoted and resented by many of his colleagues, Escalante left Garfield High. That's the bad news. The good news is that there are places where educational excellence is scaling up.
And so Colson went to some of those places. Sweden, Chile, London, India, Korea. In Korea,
the top teachers earn more than the highest paid professional baseball players.
My whole lecture revenue is over $100 million.
Really? $100 million? Colson and I will explain how that happens in the next video.